Greetings. In part 1, we examined John 1:21, wherein John the Baptist was asked whether he was the prophet. John 1:21. They asked him, "What then, are you Elijah?" And he said, "I am not." "Are you the prophet?" And he answered, "No." We then examined the source, the description, the prophecy detailing the prophet. Deuteronomy 18:15. The Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet like me from among you, from your countrymen. You shall listen to him. Deuteronomy 18:18. I will raise up a prophet from among their countrymen like you, and I will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak to them all that I command him. And we examined how Jesus perfectly fits the description of the prophet. There is another example of an apostle mentioning the prophet of Deuteronomy 18. This Moses whom they disowned, saying, "Who made you a ruler and a judge?" is the one whom God sent to be both a ruler and a deliverer with the help of the angel who appeared to him in the thorn bush. This man led them out performing wonders and signs in the land of Egypt and in the Red Sea and in the wilderness for 40 years. This is the Moses who said to the sons of Israel, "God will raise up for you a prophet like me from your brethren." So we know the apostles were aware of this prophecy from Deuteronomy 18. Is there any other mention by the prophets of a prophet who would come? Or is there any other person who might fulfill the prophecy point by point of Deuteronomy 18? Let's deal with the first question. Is there any other mention by the prophets of a prophet who would come? Malachi 3:1. Behold, I will send my messenger, who will prepare the way before me. Then the Lord whom you seek will suddenly come to his temple, the messenger of the covenant, in whom you delight. See, he is coming, says the Lord of hosts. We see in Malachi 3:1 mention of two messengers, meaning two prophets. The first will prepare the way for the second. The second is the Lord coming to his temple as a messenger or a prophet. If we examine this description, we recognize this pair, announcer and Lord prophet, were foretold in other ways as well. Isaiah 40 verse 3, a voice of one calling, "Prepare the way for the Lord in the wilderness. Make a straight highway for our God in the desert." Isaiah foretells a prophet who will prepare the way for Yahweh God. Count with me. Announcer, 1. Yahweh God, 2. The announcer, the voice, prepares the way. The announcer, the voice, prepares the way for God in the wilderness, the desert. Malachi 3:1, "Behold, I will send my messenger who will prepare the way before me." Isaiah 40 verse 3, a voice of one calling, "Prepare the way for the Lord." Both the first messenger of Malachi 3:1 and the voice of Isaiah 40 verse 3 prepare the way for God. I submit they are one in the same. So who is the voice? Who is this prophet who prepares the way for Yahweh God? Remember, this series began examining prophet John in the following verse. John 1:21. They asked him, "What then, are you Elijah?" And he said, "I am not." "Are you the prophet?" And he answered, "No." Let's keep reading. As always, context, context, context. So they said to him, "Who are you?"
Who are you?
We need an answer for those who sent us. What do you say about yourself? So if John is not the prophet, they ask him, "Who are you? Who do you say that you are?" John replied in the words of Isaiah the prophet, "I am the voice of one calling in the wilderness, make straight the way for the Lord." John has just said he is the voice, the prophet foretold by Isaiah. John has just logically identified himself as the first messenger of Malachi 3:1. John is the prophet to announce God in the earth. Remember, the first prophet announces God come in the flesh to his temple as a messenger, a prophet. "Behold, I will send my messenger who will prepare the way before me. Then the Lord whom you seek will suddenly come to his temple, the messenger of the covenant," meaning the new covenant, "in whom you delight. See, he is coming," says the Lord of hosts. Was Jesus the Messiah a prophet? Yes, and even Islam does not dare deny it. As I reviewed this, it struck me. This verse of Malachi 3:1 establishes an end date for this prophecy. "Behold, I will send my messenger who will prepare the way before me. Then the Lord whom you seek will suddenly come to his temple." This pair of prophets, one announcing God and the second God in the flesh, could only happen while a temple existed. And the temple was destroyed in 70 AD. This prophecy was either fulfilled before then or cannot until the third temple is built. Considering what Jesus himself said, the answer is clear. Luke 7:24. After John's messengers had left, Jesus began to speak to the crowds about John. "What did you go out into the wilderness to see? A reed swaying in the wind? If not, what did you go out to see? A man dressed in fine clothes? Look, those who wear elegant clothing and live in luxury are found in palaces. But what did you go out to see? A prophet? Yes, I tell you, and more than a prophet. This is the one about whom it is written, 'Behold, I will send my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way before you.'" Jesus has now also identified John as the first messenger of Malachi 3:1. Allow that to truly sink in. Jesus did not mention the voice with Isaiah's words. Jesus identified prophet John by the words of prophet Malachi. Oh, beloved in Christ, do not doubt who you have placed your faith in. Jesus, Yeshua, is God in the flesh, come to his temple. In fact, that reality makes more ominous the meaning of Jesus' words. Luke 19:41. "As Jesus approached Jerusalem and saw the city, he wept over it and said, 'If only you had known on this day what would bring you peace. But now it is hidden from your eyes. For the days will come upon you when your enemies will barricade you and surround you and hem you in on every side. They will level you to the ground, you and the children within your walls. They will not leave one stone on another, because you did not recognize the time of your visitation from God." But does that mean Jesus is the prophet of Deuteronomy 18? We have one more question to examine. Is there any other person in history who might fulfill the prophecy, point by point, of Deuteronomy 18? The person must be: 1. From Israel, 2 sent to Israel, and 3 be like Moses. There really is only one other person we need examine: the Apostle Paul. Was Paul from Israel? Acts 22:3, I am a Jew, born in Tarsus of Cilicia, but raised in this city. I was educated at the feet of Gamaliel, in strict conformity to the law of our fathers. I am just as zealous for God as any of you here today. Acts 23:6. Now when Paul perceived that one part were Sadducees and the other Pharisees, he cried out in the council, Brothers, I am a Pharisee, a son of Pharisees. It is with respect to the hope and the resurrection of the dead that I am on trial. Yes, Paul was from Israel. Paul was a Jew. In fact, any man who is not a Jew is immediately disqualified with absolute certainty. Was Paul sent to Israel? Acts 9:10. In Damascus there was a disciple named Ananias. The Lord spoke to him in a vision, Ananias. Here I am, Lord, he answered. Get up, the Lord told him. Go to the house of Judas on Straight Street and ask for a man from Tarsus named Saul, for he is praying. In a vision he has seen a man named Ananias come and place his hands on him to restore his sight. But Ananias answered, Lord, many people have told me about this man and all the harm he has done to your saints in Jerusalem. And now he is here with authority from the chief priests to arrest all who call on your name. Go, said the Lord. This man is my chosen instrument to carry my name before the Gentiles and their kings, and before the people of Israel. Paul was sent to the Gentiles. That means Paul does not faithfully meet detail number 2. Was Paul like Moses? Did Paul know God face to face? Paul met Jesus face to face on the road to Damascus. But that is not the sense of the knowledge of Deuteronomy 34:10. And while some healings happened surrounding Paul, he did not do great signs and wonders. Paul does not meet detail number 3 either. So while Paul is a reasonable candidate to consider, he does not fit the criterion of the prophet. There is literally no other person in history who fits the description. But that does not stop Satan from offering a false prophet for consideration. We will delve into that in part 3. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.